dance around Bayonetta, which is something that, you know, a lot of characters can't really claim to do. So we're going to take it to Battlefield, and this is probably a really good thing for Kid A, because she, if not landing the kill from a confirmed early percents, later percents, she's not being able to trade at all. And while having that kind of a lead, she basically is at a disadvantage because of Rage killing, netting the kills on Sheik very early. So Hardlock is going to go for the bread and butter and forward throw to Bouncing Fish. So Hardlock's taking a really good Hardlock. Really good job of stuffing out of Kid A's defensive approaches to gain stage control back. Yeah, just like we mentioned earlier, Sheik is kind of dancing around Bayonetta right now. Okay, so he throws out a Witch Time to hope to just maybe being able to bring it back there. How am I going for a read there? Okay, this time Hardlock is not able to flip the side B, and just like that, Bayonetta is racking up a lot of damage. And the second hit is going to take the stock, despite the Bat Within coming through for the first hit. But now Sheik in the lead with a very low deficit. We can definitely see some really aggressive strings here from Hardlock to get even more damage if Kid A does not keep his composure. Yeah, Kid A is definitely starting to show a little fear here. Air dodging a lot. Kid A all the way off stage. Okay, clips him with these afterburner kick. Punishing the afterburner kick to stage with the up smash. Didn't exactly get the strongest hit, but it possibly could have been the game. And the Witch Time's gonna come through. And he lands the up smash from the side B. So, Bayonetta with a bit of rage. And there we go. That's very hard to... Oh, are we gonna see the... No, we do not see the 0-2 death that Bayonetta can obviously just bring to the table. Hardlock read that extremely hard, but Kid A just spacing it just right to be able to get away with it. And just like that, 45% onto Hardlock, and it's stacking. So Kid A doing his best to bring it back, which Bayonetta definitely has one of the biggest comeback factors in the game because of her really good disadvantage options. Like Cody said earlier, having the best disadvantage state in the game, possibly. But Hardlock is definitely going to change it up. He's going to just throw needles at Kid A. Okay, yeah, forcing the ledge option with the side B there. Kid A's kind of panicking now. Throwing out two Witch Times. That's gonna take it. Hardlock just the entire game just waiting for Kid A to overcommit with the side B. So I believe Sheik typically does like light land, so we probably don't. We're not gonna see that banned. Not exactly sure where Kid A would like to go for his own personal preference as Bayonetta, but typically a lower ceiling. But he's gonna run straight back to Battlefield. So Kid A saying that it wasn't exactly the stage it was. So. You see them poke at each other. So we're seeing Kid A using a lot more upbeats to try to poke Hardlock as he whiffs, or even to beat out a possible trade option there. I'm gonna run up and grab. Oh, and just like that, he kind of just upbeats out of the combo attempt, and just like that, it's Kid A's combo. Not exactly sure about that wish time. Possibly a button error. Yeah, I like that little mix-up there for going to the stage and back to ledge, but Harlock is still able to catch him after he does that. And another wish time coming from Kid A. This could possibly not work out in Kid A's favor because Harlock is now playing very patient and playing the matchup really well. Going for a Hail Mary up smash, possibly get the diamond cutter. And Kid A takes the stock with that whip. Come on, grab onto the platform. Harlock. So now with. This is where Sheik does not like to be behind and approaching the percent margin where she cannot kill you with a confirm. But which time is going to save Kid A there? So now, it all comes down to not taking any trades from Kid A. Well, he does get the air dodge. I believe that's he was scouting out, but he wasn't in a position to possibly go for a downer. He gets the which time. Oh, this could be it. Oh, he messes up. He goes in the wrong direction. Nah, she's gonna make that back. For a second there, I thought Harlock accidentally missed and that trap there. To take it. Oh, I believe he wanted a footstool there, possibly. I'm not exactly sure.
Oh, just side beat.
Just side beat straight out. Oh. This might. Nope. Harlock just slithering out of there. And this is very scary for Harlock. Another wish line coming from Kid A is going to get him heavily punished. You generally want to save wish time for a pet. Oh! That's it. Kid A takes game two. And we saw definitely a bit of the struggles in the matchup for Sheik just now because Kid A was able to completely take away the first stock off of one with punish. So Harlock is definitely going to want to change it up here. He's going to run into Smashville. So arguably Sheik's best stage, considering she can change whatever she would like to onto the Smashville platform. But we are going to see it versus Bayonetta. So. See what Harlock thinks. He gets caught in the very strong jab there. So Kid A is definitely going to want to do his best here to mix it up as much as possible. I'm not exactly sure if he's going to throw out more wish times or probably less. He's got to keep it nice and fresh because he did net him the kill last game. Just barely missing that bounce of it. So, oh, he baited. He waited perfectly for that up smash setup, but he's not gonna get it. Excellent scout there from Harlock. Cool. Reverse needles into the up air. Harlock definitely has the patience to provide to punish Bayonetta's panic option. Oh, he gets the last hit of the up air, but it doesn't net the kill. So now Sheik, never mind. He nets the confirm with the reverse needles into the bouncing fish. Now, Sheik at the advantage. Kind of just bob in, bob out. Get whatever she would like. So now. Kid A is going. Yeah, there we have another panic wish time to possibly net the stock. But Kid A just throwing it out. Kind of stuffing out Harlock there. And I think that he went for that really. There's possibly a reverse hit on the heel slide there. I do believe he did hit it in a previous game, probably game one. Not exactly sure. But Harlock is going to play the waiting game. back. He is Sheik. Going for the mix up there. And Kid A is going for a lot of pattern options, and that might not do it. But Harlock is completely in position to punish these side B's, but he isn't able to react in time, so he just lets it drop, so he doesn't have a chance of losing control, and that's going to net the game 3. Harlock's adaptation coming in very clutch for that game. And he's going to take the set 3, 2-1, I'm saying.